What happens when you dissolve salt in water? Well, as we've talked about, for example, sodium chloride, right? So sodium chloride, when in aqueous environment, we know that this will be converted to a sodium cation and a chloride anion, right? So when this ionic compound is surrounded by water, then the water molecules can surround sodium through ion-dipole interactions and surround chloride by ion-dipole interactions. And we end up with a solution of sodium cations and chloride anions that are fairly distinct from each other, and they have the ability to undergo reactions by themselves if they can. Right? And that idea that each of these two ions are now available to react with other things is kind of the basis of why some ionic compounds, when dissolved in water, will create an acidic or a basic solution. Let's take, for example, sodium fluoride instead of sodium chloride. So sodium fluoride is also nice and soluble in water, and when it dissolves in water, we create a sodium cation and a fluoride anion. Right? So the only difference in the products between these two reactions is the presence of a chloride anion versus the presence of a fluoride anion. And this is a really important difference because chloride is the conjugate base of hydrochloric acid, right? We know that if we have hydrochloric acid reacting with water under an acid dissociation reaction, we know hydrochloric acid is a strong acid, so we completely convert it to chloride and to hydronium. Okay? So chloride is the conjugate base of a strong acid, meaning this reaction, chloride will not react with water to be converted back over here. This does not happen. So chloride does not undergo a base dissociation reaction to produce hydrochloric acid because hydrochloric acid is a strong acid, and the products are a strong acid and a strong base, and they would completely revert back to reactants. So this reaction does not happen. Chloride is not able to serve as a base and react with water. Fluoride, however, is, right? So fluoride is a weak base, and when it reacts with water, it undergoes a base dissociation reaction to produce HF, a weak acid, and hydroxide. Consequently, if we dissolve sodium fluoride in water, the fluoride that gets produced will react with water and make hydroxide. So when sodium fluoride gets dissolved in water, we produce a weak base, which makes some hydroxide. So a solution of sodium fluoride will absolutely have a basic pH because in this compound is a weak base. Okay? Another example is, let's say we have ammonium chloride. So ammonium chloride is readily soluble in water, so it will dissolve to make an ammonium cation and a chloride anion. Well, as we just said, chloride is the conjugate base of a strong acid, so it will not participate in acid-base chemistry. But ammonium will. Ammonium is a weak acid which will react with water to produce the ammonia. Ammonia, and in this case, hydronium. So when ammonium chloride dissolves in water, there's some hydronium that's produced, so this will create an acidic solution. Okay, the big punchline here is that if the ionic compound contains a weak acid, then the solution will be acidic. If the ionic compound dissolves in water and contains a weak base, then the solution will be basic. How about this situation? So let's imagine dissolving sodium bicarbonate in water. Right? This is nice and soluble, and when it dissolves, we produce a sodium cation and a hydrogen carbonate anion. Well, bicarbonate is one of these amphiprotic molecules, right? So this is something you should have learned about in your reading. So amphiprotic means that it can be an acid or a base. So it has the ability to react with water and accept a proton, or react with water and donate a proton. So there are two possible reactions that bicarbonate can undergo. So it can react with water to produce hydroxide, in which case we generate carbonic acid, or it can react with water in an acid dissociation reaction and produce hydronium and its conjugate base carbonate, right? So these are two possible reactions that the bicarbonate ion can undergo with water: acid dissociation or base dissociation. So the question is which of these will produce more product, right? Because if the base dissociation reaction has a larger equilibrium constant, then more hydroxide will be produced. But if the acid dissociation reaction has a larger equilibrium constant, then more hydronium will be produced. So the trick to this is to look up the acid dissociation constant for the two reactions here and compare them, right? So we need an equilibrium constant for each of these two reactions. Okay, so let's refer to our table of pKa values. Okay, and I'll note that it's a table of pKa values, meaning we're only going to find the values for acid dissociation reactions. So we will find this first reaction directly, but we're going to need to figure out the pKb for the base dissociation reaction. Okay, so looking at this table here, we find hydrogen carbonate, right? We see bicarbonate here. It has a pKa of 10.33. So that acid dissociation reaction has a pKa of 10.33, or the Ka will be 10 to the negative 10.33. Let's compare this to the equilibrium constant for the base dissociation reaction. Our process here is we want to find the conjugate acid of bicarbonate, which is carbonic acid, right? So we have carbonic acid here. This is the pKa, so the pKb is going to be 14 minus this, so 7.65. Okay, so bicarbonate has a pKb of 7.65, so the equilibrium constant is 10 to the negative 7.65. Okay, so this is our base dissociation constant, this is our acid dissociation constant. And since this value is larger, since the Kb value is larger, this means bicarbonate is a better base than it is an acid. Okay, so it's a better base than it is an acid. So this reaction has the larger equilibrium constant, meaning the concentration of hydroxide we produce will be larger than the concentration of hydronium. So when you dissolve sodium bicarbonate in water, will create a basic solution, not an acidic solution, because bicarbonate is a better base than it is an acid.